Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Mama Sandy. How are you doing? Today is another day for our Monarch Butterfly racing adventure. Just a quick disclaimer, if you're not into caterpillar, you're not into creepy crawly, please feel free to walk away. Anyway, how are you doing? I do hope you guys are having a great weekend, because I am. So as you can see, I am showing you some of my I wouldn't really say a pet, but my hobby, racing a monarch butterfly and other types of butterfly. So right now this is the stage where all the caterpillars are in. I had them in a container because, oh my god, they're pretty much crawling all over, even in my neighbor's wall, and they're not happy about it, so I have to put them in a cage. So I picked them, I put them in a container, and then transferred them into my old lizard container or a cage. So this one, the one you're seeing in my hands, are the chrysalis, or the cocoon as they call it in some other places. And this is the fritillary butterfly, or gulf fritillary butterfly. So many of you would probably ask me why I raise butterfly for hobby. I can share to you that butterflies really inspire me, because there are times in my life that I felt really unhappy and not feeling well. So every time I have that moment, I would go to my garden and I notice that the butterflies are there. And when I look up into the internet about them and their life cycle, I am so amazed how interesting they are. Because from the moment that a female butterfly lay eggs on the host plants, the eggs and becomes the tiny, minuscule caterpillar, and they fend for themselves. They start eating and eating and eating, and then they become so fat and engorged, and they become into this beautiful chrysalis or cocoon. And after that, a few days later, they become into a butterfly, and as soon as their wings dried up, they fly out and they hunt for food, which is in this case, they like to go to flowers for nectar. And after that, they mate, find a partner, and they mate and they lay eggs again. And after that, they die. So to sum up, butterflies don't stop for nothing. They will go on regardless of what's happening around them, whether if it's too sunny, too hot, or it's raining, or there's a storm, they still go and do what they're supposed to do. The bottom line, life is too short and we should enjoy it regardless of what's going on around us. Have a good weekend, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this video. Mahalo. Thank you so much.